ago going 1-2. They'd like to improve on that this go around. And what a joy to be.
This is Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and Doris Burke, our game analyst. And from the sideline, David Aldridge. We'll see the Indiana Pacers defending home turf in the Eastern Conference. First chance of the season for them to go up against this Wizards team. And last year, they were able to take the edge in the series thanks to some clutch play.
And they were able to take the season series in that matchup last year. But overall, two teams that were very similar in the standings.
Season ahead, but these early season games count just as much as the games in March and April.
Well, we have seen over the last couple years, Kevin, in both the Eastern and Western Conference, that sometimes it's a game or two separating whether or not you have home court advantage in the playoffs. The games matter in late October and early November, and the good teams understand that.
So a look at the starters for the Wizards. Porter and Morris, the duo at forward. The always dangerous Wall and Beal are the backcourt. And it's Gortat in at the five spot. Now, here is Young. Outside Robinson. Six on the shot clock. T kicks to Turner. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. And an impressive rookie season for Miles Turner, Greg. A bit of a slow start after requiring thumb surgery, but once he got out on the floor, he gave signs that he can be the Pacers' pivot of the future.
A millennial big man.
Yes.
Really, he's got the shot blocking and the ability to shoot it deep. Those kinds of players are really rare. Big-time upside. They did very well for themselves with that number 11 pick.
First one falls for him.
And the Pacers, really, for so long, kind of defined that old school plotting defensive oriented team, and then they just flipped the script last season. I mean, completely reinventing themselves, playing much of that season with four perimeter players on the court and finding ways to be successful at doing it.
And the Pacers had great success in the past, but they just felt they couldn't score enough with the two big men clogging up the middle.
Yeah, and the crazy thing is that even going smaller, they were still a top five defensive team. They found some big men who can shoot from the perimeter now, and what you like is that they have flexibility in terms of their style of play.
Now cheap. Bradley Beal missing from long range. Robinson for three. Great D that time from Beal. Beyond the arc. Wall, no luck. Looking at the last game for the Indiana Pacers, it was a win against the Detroit Pistons. Screened by Young. Off the pick. Gortat with the steal. Robinson against Beal. Outside, Wall. Beal dishes to Wall. Morris with the screen for Wall. Fires the three. Tries again. And it's sent back by George.
You know, simply not finding a flow. Just 1 for 5 to start this game.
Here's Young. The shot. No good. Gortat with the defensive effort. Here's Wall. The Pacers pull it in.
Incredible defense. Takes real courage to risk getting posterized and come up with a big stop.
Washington's gone 0-3 from three-point land. Nothing yet going outside. And a wide-open look for Porter. Buries it from three-point range.
Just seemed to know where to be and had his feet set. Looking good is Otto Porter on the catch and shoot.
T kicks to Young. Left side, George. To the inside, Turner. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. And as we have a moment now, let's take a look at the three-pointer to two-pointer shot ratio here in the postseason for the Pacers. He's made one and missed one so far in the game.
And from the line a season ago, 73%.
That's good from Turner. Oubre is checked in for Gortat. Both free throws good from Turner. And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. And Wall kicks to Oubre. Pass to Morris. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
Boy, when you see Markieff Morris, you can't help but think about what went down in Phoenix with him. There certainly was some fighting going on between him and other teammates. He demanded a trade several times, eventually just taken out of the rotation, even though his skill was good enough to be on the floor.
With Morris and his Phoenix exit, eventually, Doris, he was traded to the Wizards, and that was a move that was probably best for everyone involved.
Right, Kevin. It made you wonder why they didn't do it sooner. Things started to go south in Phoenix when Markieff felt betrayed by the organization for trading his brother away. And luckily, all that's in the past, and Markieff can focus on just playing basketball.
George, no good. For the Washington Wizards, they won their last contest that game against the Detroit Pistons. And it's Wall in the corner. Here's Beal. And count the basket. Hit. He was fouled.
That's
and he's
good.
Going to the line for one more.
Hit. One shot.
Boy, that is a rugged finish from Beal. Absorbs the hit, guides it in. Nice.
Well, for Bradley Beal, he's just an incredible three-point shooter, and Doris always has been since he came into the league out of Florida after growing up in the St. Louis area.
Well, think about this, Kevin. Beal has never averaged less than 4 3-point attempts a game in his career. This is one of the most consistent three-point threats in the NBA, and his shot is effortless. With how well this guy shoots, you almost wish he could shoot more often and see how far he can take his game.
Now, here is George. Here's Turner, and the rebound paying off as they pick up two on the second chance bucket right there.
Boy, kept the possession alive with the offensive rebound. You have to love the effort and getting the putback opportunity.
An easy 2 points on the layup.
Well, a terrific secondary playmaker. Beal with a nice find.
T kicks to Young. Indiana moving the ball over. And it's Robinson with the jam.
That's picture perfect timing on that play on the part of both the passer and the cutter.
Ball against T. Outside Wall. Dishes it to Morris. Shot clock at 5. Unloads from 13. Not going to go that time. And Indiana will come the other way. Teague with a clean look. No good from outside.
And they had some botched coverage that turned into no coverage.
Now the feed to Beal. Here is Porter. Morris right side. Count it from 12.
Morris making things look easy right now. What a rhythm.
Pacers trail by 7. He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, I spoke briefly with Nate McMillan. This is the first meeting of the year between these two teams, but he said those guys are tough to deal with when you let them get to the rim. We've got to move our feet on defense and do our best to deny penetration. We'll see who comes out on top, Kevin.
Okay, David, much appreciated. So the wing on the left, and Robinson wide open. He shoots. That 3 off the mark. Outside Wall. Beal gets a wide open look. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim.
Ooh, he was open there, guys. I'm sure he's kicking himself that he didn't capitalize.
Robinson kicks to Turner. Oubre with the steal. Feeds to Porter. Score the basket. His 2nd of 2 attempts.
Tough to bother that shot, right? Otto Porter with prototypical size and length at the small forward.
Screen by Young. Teague inside the line. Kept alive. Oh, and the dunk by Young.
And guys, isn't it great to see a player who works that hard on the glass at both ends?
Well said, G. That's the way he has built, you know, his reputation. Grinding away, 100% effort all the time.
So much tenacity. Really tries to outwork everyone around him.
And so it's Washington with it, following the score by Indiana. Morris with the bucket.
They've had assists now on their last three baskets.
So timeout called here, the first for Indiana. Teams were last season's best passers. The squads with the most assists in the NBA. The Wizards fifth.
Just a gifted passing team. They play the kind of basketball that fans love to watch. Very unselfish and fluid offensively.
Pacers trail by seven. Outside Teague. On the wing, Turner. Two free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. It's going to go on Markieff Morris.
You know, when the Wizards last season went small, I thought they struggled on the boards. They went from a team that was top four in rebounding to bottom six. They simply have got to do a better job on the glass.
Shooting two.
That free throw missing. And the Wizards with Markieff Morris at the four and Gortat at center. You like that front line?
Like Kevin, I certainly think there's some talent there, and that's certainly a gifted offensive front court. It comes down to rebounding and rim protection. Can they get the job done there?
C.J. Miles, he's checked in for the Pacers. And he sinks the second. Here is Wall. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. He dishes it to Oubre. Here's the three. Wall's shot is off.
Not a quarter to remember as far as his offense is concerned.
No, it feels like he's forcing things, getting a little frustrated by not letting the game come to him.
Norris, the NBA is consistently evolving, changing all the time. What are the biggest changes you've seen in the league over the years?
Well, this should be an interesting conversation, because if you think about Michael Jordan's era and how little impact the three-point shot had on the game, to the point where 2 years ago Greg Popovich says, Kevin,
take
and you've
break.
Been calling
take
the
a
NBA
break.
A lot longer than
two
I have,
shot.
You can't win without the three-point ball. It's simply impossible. Would you say that that's been the single most significant change?
Probably brought more in focus with what Curry and Thompson have done. I love the ball movement.
It's
the
a game lot of
is,
fun.
The game is so much more pleasing to the eye now than, say, in the 90s.
Okay, and let me ask you this. So we talk about the three-point shot. The other thing with Golden State, and you mentioned Stephen Clay, this small ball, is that sort of a revolutionary thing that perhaps is not going to go back?
Well, the athletic ability, the length of their arm span, the ability to jump, they can almost equal what a big man would do, even in a smaller frame, a different kind of form, and maybe they've been able to adjust that way. I mean, what do you think?
It's as you know, and you know this better than I do, it's a sort of a reactionary league. And so you saw a team like Washington go away from a double low post that got them to the Eastern Conference Finals, try to play small, and they take a step back.
Yes. Good point.
Just impressed with the teamwork out there, setting the table for one another.
You got this, man.
Now here's Brooks. Burke covering. And there's the pass to Miles. Jefferson kicks to Brooks. There's the pick. Screen by Jefferson. Just four to shoot. Deep two from Robinson. Kept alive by Indiana. Turner. Score the basket. His second of two attempts.
And already they've staked out a noticeable advantage in terms of aggression and controlling the backboard.
And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. Well, for the Pacers last season, they trade Roy Hibbert to the Los Angeles Lakers. David West took far less money, Greg, to leave town. You worried about their front court, that it would be in shambles?
Yeah, and instead, rookie Miles Turner showed himself to be a steal as a shot-blocking, perimeter-shooting big. And it was a best-case scenario. If they could build on that, I think they have a chance to be one of the contenders in that Eastern Conference.
Allen's checked in for Miles Turner. Thornton drops two.
You know, such a polished free throw shooter. He just makes the most of all of those chances when he gets them.
Robinson kicks to Allen. Now the dish to Brooks. Passes it to Jefferson. This is his first free throw of the game.
At the line for two.
That free throw good from Al Jefferson.
Now for the Wizards, we know their playoff hopes always hinge on the continued all-star play of point guard John Wall. He's the engine, there's no doubt, that makes everything go for this team offensively.
And both free throws good for Jefferson. Washington leading now by four. Now here's Burke. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Off target with his three. And Torres, the Wizards, one of the better passing teams in the league last season, tied for third most assists, and the turnovers not bad at all.
Well, I think, Kevin, so much of the play creation responsibility falls on John Wall's shoulders. And to become more dynamic offensively, I think they need other players on their roster to be more active breaking down the defense.
And if they know what's good for them, that's the way they'll defend against him every time he takes the ball in the three-point lane.
It's good. And the Wizards lead by six.
And something we don't see nearly as much as we used to, the finger roll.
There's a screen by Robinson. Brooks kicks to Miles. And he gets that one to go off the front iron. Washington has gone a meager 1-6 from three-point land since we got started tonight. Smith with a screen on Robinson. And a wide open look for Thornton. And a miss there on the triple. The Pacers shooting in this first quarter around 38%. They're looking a bit creaky out there. Here's Jefferson. And the rejection by Smith. And they're pushing it up. It's good, the assist that time from Burke. Smith's got his first basket.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Screen by Jefferson from deep. Brooks sinks the three-pointer.
There's a chance he could go for a big game if they don't beat him up on the perimeter.
Burke kicks to Nicholson. Screen by Smith. Thornton passes to Smith. It's stolen by Jefferson. Brooks dishes to Miles off his leg, and the official saying it was kicked. Brooks outside. Lets it go from 11. Shots good by Jefferson. Now just a one-point Wizards lead. 1:12 left in the first. Burke kicks to Thornton. Smith up top. It's tipped. Out in his own on the break. Here's Miles. And then C.J. Miles with the dunk.
And that's up-tempo basketball at its best. So much easier to operate the open court when a steal triggers the break.
Now here's Burke. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. He kicks to Thornton. Puts up a three. No good that time. Some solid defense from Robinson. Over to the left wing. To the middle. And there's Al Jefferson on the assist by Robinson. 6 points for Al Jefferson.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Burke kicks to Smith. Oubre passes to Nicholson, and Allen with the block. Now, here's Miles. He's covered closely. Now, Brooks. Kicks to Jefferson. Smith with the defensive effort. And still a close game as the first quarter comes to a close. It's the Pacers leading by three. And back with the start of the second quarter in just a moment. John Wall spoke prior to the game. He talked about the identity of the Wizards team.
Defensively, just being that gritty and grimy team that makes it tough for teams to score in the paint. I think we can be a very great team.
The Wizards, not exactly the first team that you think of when it comes to gritty and grimy team defense, but maybe he's really got a point here in how tough the Washington defense can be.
And you don't get there without the defense. I'm especially impressed that Wall has that mindset.
Neither team able to build much of a lead up to this point as we start the second quarter. And let's quickly break down the game, guys, we have seen from Indiana. What do you think?
You can tell the point of emphasis has been to get to the offensive glass.
You know, and they're doing that in a number of ways, flying in from the perimeter when the ball goes up, as well as just gaining good old-fashioned position down low.
So this is how the floor looks for the Wizards starting the second. Morris pairs with Gortat down low. All out there with Sadarans, and it's Porter in at the threesome. Out there, one in the Indiana lead has been cut down now to just three on the bucket from Wall.
You can see the satisfaction John Wall takes in making those jumpers. He continues to improve in that area.
Screened by Young. On the wing, George. He feeds it to Young. Morris with the rebound. Morris has got rebound number five here tonight.
Well, just watch Markieff Morris play, and you can see why he's such a threat in the front court. He's got the size and speed to guard either the three or the four, and that gives you options as a coach defensively. Very smooth, easy jump shot. This is a really talented big.
Miles Turner, he's checked in for Jefferson. And Morris isn't shy about letting it fly from deep. Not the most consistent shooter from range, but Morris, he'll make you pay if you leave him alone, and he'll certainly keep you honest defensively.
Well, I think, Kevin, when Morris plays and moves, it just looks like he is a shooting guard with a fluidity of motion. You almost forget that he's a legit 6'10 because of the ease he has putting the ball on the deck to create a shot. There are not a lot of players his size as comfortable doing the moves he does to get open and find looks.
Now Young, following the three-point attempt by John Wall. Wall against Brooks. Young, a screen on Wall. Lock at six. T kicks to Brooks. Three-pointer. Porter pulls it in. Wizards have gone 2 of 3 from the field here to open the second quarter. He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, guys, in the era of 3-and-D and 4-out-and-1-in, some say the post-up is a lost art. That makes Al Jefferson a throwback player. He said it happened right in front of my eyes. When I came into the league, it was still a big man's game. Everything changed around me. I've always been a back-to-the-basket, post-move player. Just stuck to what I do best, guys.
Yeah, and I hope he never changes. Thanks, D.A.
Well, 2016, guys, saw a great stride for Otto Porter in his career. He got off to that slow start, remember, the first 2 years. But finally, when he got consistent minutes, he answered nicely. Career highs across the board for him. And you can see why this team thinks he's got a bright future.
And Porter drops them both. And with Porter, so many were quick to dismiss his place, Doris, in the NBA after a few slow years to start his career.
And I think, Kevin, that goes back to where he was picked in the draft, third overall. And when you're a top three pick, fans want instant production. And Porter was always the kind of player that needed time to adjust to this league. Luckily, the organization believed in him, stuck with him. He's made huge improvements across the board.
Oh, and he went for the two-hander on the slam using some muscle.
Some urgency from him there, sure. All against Brooks. Young with the steal. Brooks dishes to T. Pass to Young. Screen by Young. Not enough on that one as it misses. Washington shooting here about 46% for the game. Gortat with a screen on Brooks. They set the pick. Here's Morris. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. And for Thaddeus Young, extremely effective last season after signing a 4-year, $50 million contract. Definitely made an effort to earn that money.
And for a guy who didn't operate much out of the post, he still took high percentage shots. You saw the hustle, his ability to rack up steals, the improved rebounding. He moves his feet well enough to play the three and worked on his strength enough to where he can also play the four.
Beal's checked in for Washington. And Morris drops them both.
Among the league's big men, he stands out for his free throw shooting. He's always steady there.
Brooks kicks to Turner. Teague with the ball. Looking for his first basket still in this one. I read somewhere Jeff Teague said that if he wasn't an NBA player, he'd be a battle rap.
Well, that's a pretty unique answer. And I know he likes to battle when he's out on the floor. So Teague is also a big sneakerhead, as they're called, has a huge collection of those as well.
Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Doris, a lot of great young players come into the NBA. Which do you think could be the best in the league in a few years?
Well, I think certainly Anthony Davis comes to mind because of how skilled he is. We were talking earlier about the five position, how it's changing. You know, you've got Anthony Davis who's now stretched his range to 3-point. He's got mid-range game. He can go back to the basket. He's dynamic in the open floor and a real presence on the defensive end. I can't wait to see what happens with Anthony Davis.
Well, somebody taught him well when he was young because his handle's good and he plays almost the position like a point guard.
Yeah, that's a great point. I think that's the key. I think he played that position earlier in his career because he had that great growth spurt. But I think Anthony Davis, you know, it's about the skills, certainly, but it's about the work ethic and the IQ, and he's got the whole package.
Smart kid.
And now only one away from being in the penalty.
And in the second quarter, a little under 3.5 minutes played already.
Well, shooters are necessary to win in this league, and Porter can provide that kind of floor spacing.
Beal against T. Left side, George. Gortat with the steal. Wall up top. Brooks covering. Here's Morris. So the whistle blows on the shot, and two free throws for the contact right there.
And one of the more aggressive teams in the league this past offseason, looking to adjust their roster, the Indiana Pacers. I mean, the trade for Jeff Teague, another for Thaddeus Young, the signing of Al Jefferson. It's going to be interesting to see how all these new players gel in Nate McMillan's system.
And Jeff Teague of Atlanta and now of Indiana, more of a playmaking point guard. That's something the Pacers have lacked for a long time, GA.
Yeah, and he's a guy who looks to push the ball aggressively in transition. And that's something, as you mentioned, the Pacers have been trying to do. Thaddeus Young, another player who fits that mold. Jefferson, more of a half court, but I think he gives them a nice option there with that second unit.
They're running. It's hauled in by Paul George. Pacers trail by four. Trying his luck deep, and once again off the mark by Indiana. Here's Washington. They're on a 13-4 run. And Beal kicks to Porter. Back to Beal. Six to shoot. And there's the call on Marcin Gortat. That's his third foul of the game. Indiana's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Teague kicks to Turner. Screened by Young. Her passes to Teague. And it's slammed in by Teague.
Look at the explosiveness from the little man. Teague just rises up and never stops.
Wall dishes to Morris. There's a good screen. Top of the key, Beal. Off the screen. Buries the jump shot. Beal's got five now.
Yeah, simply great vision on that pass. Knew exactly where that pass needed to be and threaded it right through the teeth.
Brooks kicks the tee. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Brooks. 6 points for Teague.
And Teague is just so calm and collected when he gets near the rim.
Outside, Wall. Morris right side. Off target from outside. For Indiana, they've gotten a little under 50% of their second quarter shots to find the mark. 4 of 9 all told. Indiana moving it around. Young sets a screen for George. Jacks up a three. And he's good on the three ball. And it's 7 points for Thaddeus Young.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agendas. Now a chance to see the numbers for George. Coming off a terrific season. 9th in steals, 10th in scoring. And he'd make you pay every time he went to the line. Top 20 in free throw percentage.
Washington trailing. Outside, Wall. Let's go. And the whistle blows, and it's going to be an over-the-back call here.
He looked clumsy on that one. He was not going to get away with that.
And some changes here for the Pacers. C.J. Miles comes in for George. Robinson is subbed in for Aaron Brooks. And the Wizards making a change here as well. Oubre's checked in. There's a screen by Robinson. And here is Teague. He's got six. Here's Miles. Misses the chippy right there.
You know what? You just cannot get much better of a look than that one.
Yeah, that's the look you're working toward with your offense. Hurts when you don't hit it.
Now here's Beal. He's got five. Launches it. Robinson pulls it in.
That's a look you cannot pass up. It's also one you should miss.
Here's Turner. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. It's going to go on Otto Porter Jr. Doris, you've worked with so many coaches in so many different ways throughout your career. You were a player and you were an assistant coach yourself and as a broadcaster now. Do you ever see yourself maybe back on the sidelines?
Yeah, you know, that's how I started my career, Kevin. I've always thought that when my broadcasting career is over, I miss the competition. I miss working with a group of players to sort of achieve something special. So no question, I see myself back there.
And he looks totally out of sorts here at the stripe. Those defenders aren't afraid at all to body him up and force him to earn his points at the line.
But making a change here. Allen's checked in. Marcus Thornton, he's checked in for Washington. Burke comes in for John Wall. And he sinks the second. Washington has gone 1 of 4 from 3-point range in the second. Not a whole lot dropping out there for them. Edwards out with the screen for Oubre. Inside. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a three-point play.
That's called too big and too strong. Gortat throws off the defender.
Al Jefferson has checked in for Indiana.
The remarkable thing to me, the Wizards last season looking to go small and try to jumpstart their middling offense. Instead, the offense stays static, and their once elite defense fell the middle of the pack.
Now, here's Miles. Pass to Robinson. Dishes to Jefferson. Misses off the left iron. Wizards have gone 5 of 11 from the field since the beginning of the second quarter. Oubre, that one falls, coming off Burke's feet.
Coaches can't get enough of those easy looks in the post.
Indiana trailing here. Screen by Jefferson. Teague kicks to Jefferson. Outside for Robinson. The feed to Teague. Five to shoot. Puts it up from 15. Again, the miss by Jefferson.
The shot's there for him, and he's got to take it. I don't care if he doesn't convert. That's a shot he has to continue to take.
Now, here's Burke. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Wizards need to get a shot off here. Beal can't get it to go.
He's been somewhat off this quarter, but the desire to score is evident.
T kicks to Robinson. Gets to the corner and buries it. Robinson's got the game tied up here for the Pacers.
And Teague knew that he would be open there. Great patience and vision from the point man.
Back to Burke. To the paint. It's deflected. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
Shot done.
There are a lot of great things that Gortat does on the floor, Doris, but you feel that he doesn't sometimes get enough credit for his rebound.
Well, I think you'd probably concur with that, Kevin, because year after year, Gortat is near the top of the league in rebounding. This guy's one of the best at tipping the ball to himself to secure the rebound. And not only does he get a lot, Kevin, but he does it in limited amounts of time. There are a lot of guys getting a lot more minutes at that position.
Thaddeus Young, he's checked in for Indiana. Nicholson's checked in for Washington. He's off on the second.
Boy, showing a lot more aggressiveness now after making zero trips to the line in the first quarter.
And that'll be Indiana as it goes out of bounds. Pacers retain possession. And Washington making a change here. Smith has checked in. Here is Miles. Back to Young. Some nice passing here by Indiana. And there's Miles. That's good on the assist by Robinson. Miles has got 6 points. We've seen the lead change hands quite a bit in this one.
And guys, I think each team knows they can win this game. Just a matter of who can catch that momentum.
Now, here's Burke. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. And another miss by Washington.
More good work on the glass there. When it's all said and done, I think rebounding might tell the story in this game.
Robinson misses.
No other way to put it. Just a poor shooting performance for him. But luckily, his teammates have picked up the slack.
Now, here's Burke. Teague covering. And Thornton kicks to Burke. Feeds to Oubre. Shot clock at 5. Thornton. And he uses the glass on the layup. He has 6.
You always hear about chemistry. That's a perfect example. Knowing where each other is at all times.
Teague left side. Fires from deep. And he's good on the 3-ball. And that's now 10 points for Thaddeus Young.
Guys, his consistency in terms of shooting has really helped them seize control.
Smith with a screen on Robinson. There's 1:26 left to play here in the second quarter. Burt can't get it to go.
And that's how you have to defend him out there on the three-point line. Played him perfectly.
And really, he epitomizes what a point guard should be. I mean, his skill as a passer might actually be matched by that creativity he shows around the rim.
Well, judging by that jam, Greg, I'd say you're absolutely right.
Yeah, he's rising to the occasion as you're trying to keep pace on the scoreboard. You know, you've got to give the nod to that setup. Very nice assist makes that basket so easy.
Outside Teague. Young outside. From past the arc. Another miss by Young. Washington trailing. Burke kicks to Thornton. Down low, here's Gortat. Jefferson with some nice D.
As long as he makes his presence known, sometimes that's all it takes to change the shot.
To the paint, and that'll be Indiana as it goes out of bounds. Pacers retain possession.
Well, close to picking that one off.
Great anticipation, just a little late getting his hand in there.
Satoransky's checked in for Washington. Knocked away. Young passes to Robinson. And Miles kicks to Young. Shot clock at 6. From deep. Satoransky grabs the miss. From deep. No good on the buzzer beater. And we're through the first half of basketball here in what's been a good one. Pacers lead by 2. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Bradley. The old saying, no rebounds, no rings. How important is it to continue to have 5 guys go to the glass in the second half?
Yeah, all five guys. I think we're too worried about getting out in transition. So I think 1 through 5, including the guards, we all got to get in there and rebound.
Can't score unless you have the ball, right? Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, David, and we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here again with Shaq and Kenny. And an exciting time of the year as one of the first games of the regular season is halfway through. For the Pacers, the first quarter was pretty even. At the end of the period, they held a 3-point lead. The second quarter saw them lose just a fraction of the lead they held at the end of the first, as they're now ahead by 2 points at the half. And Kenny, what'd you think about what we saw from Indiana?
Well, their reserves showed up tonight, not just on hustle plays, but in points. And that's what you got to do coming off the bench to maximize your minutes.
And over to Shaq, your take on the Wizards.
Well, if you can't shoot the ball, you might want to stop chucking it up. They keep trying the three, but it's not going down. They're relying too much on the three ball. Way too much. It's good when it's falling for you, but when it's not, you have to try something else.
That's it for halftime. We will see you and you and you too later. Now back to the action.
A flyover of downtown gives you a great perspective of our location as we welcome you back to Indianapolis. Here we go now, the start of the third quarter, welcoming you back in a closely contested first half so far. A fantastic game from Miles Turner in this one.
Yeah, the rebounding, particularly on the offensive side, as good as it gets. He was bringing the effort down low.
Well, it's his specialty. There are certain guys who can dominate a half or even an entire game by generating second chances.
Indiana leading. George and Young are the forwards. Robinson is out there with Teague, and it's Jefferson in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. So that's the group out there for Indiana. Teague can't hit. Morris outside to the inside. Horzot, and foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. Well, you just have to love the motor of Gortat. Always is moving to open space doors, keeping the defense on their toes. And when the ball goes up, you know he's going to be crashing.
Well, I think, Kevin, you would agree that very few other big men move as much as Gortat. He's got great timing on when to dive in for a rebound, and his movement creates so much chaos for opponents. And I think it also opens up opportunities for the guys around him.
Turner's checked in for Al Jefferson. Drops. He ties it up.
How about Gortat, guys? Really an ambassador for his home country of Poland. He loves that cultural exchange. And how about this? Speaks four languages.
Now here's Turner. The three from George. Beal pulls it in. Outside Wall. There's a screen by Gortat. Wall kicks to Gortat, and Gortat with the stuff.
I tell you, they're getting a great lift from Gortat right now. He's rolling offensively.
And it's Young at the elbow. From 13, Morris with the block.
I mean, simply put, they're out of sync. 0 for 3 coming out of the break.
Let's it fly from 18. Wow, way off on that one.
Neither coach nor his teammates are pleased with the way he's playing. He's simply got to adjust his shot selection.
And George kicks the tee. Left side Turner. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Count it. Turner's got it all tied up now for the Pacers.
Well, it took 4 tries, but they get their first bucket in the second half.
There's a screen by Gortat. Wall kicks to Beal. On the wing, and an air ball on that one. Way off. Pacers have gotten just one of their first 4 shots to fall since coming out of the lock to break. And that's a foul called on Bradley Beal. That's foul number 2 for him.
Yeah, clearly he had an established position there.
2 minutes gone in this third quarter now. In the corner, George with it, expanding his range.
Tough start to the second half, just 1-5, wow.
And the ball goes out of bounds, last touch by Morris. Teague against Wall, the pass to Turner. Ball's knocked loose. Not quite 2.5 minutes played here in the second half.
Isn't this what coaches love to see? Morris getting after it defensively, challenging shots everywhere.
Porter. And that comes off the assist by John Wall. Wall's got 6 assists in the game. T kicks to Turner. Here's Young. And then jammed down as he goes right over Marquise Morris.
And that is a punch to the jaw. This game, as tight as it can be, and he pulls something off that we might not even see in the All-Star game.
Ooh, well, I don't think he planned it too far in advance. That was one of those things, you know, Greg, that just happens. Special thanks to Kia for that sweet Kia Slam Cam replay. Now, here is Young, following the miss by John Wall. George missing again. The Wizards have gone 2 of 5, shooting here in the third quarter. Wall kicks to Gortat, and that one is off. Good work defensively by Turner. Teague dishes to George. For the lead, nail from three-point land. And it's a 3-point Pacer lead.
Just a great job there from Teague to locate where his teammate was and get the ball to him on time.
Wall wide open, and they come right back with their own 3-pointer.
And how about that
for a response.
Didn't take them any time to get those 3 points back. That's the shot they wanted.
Now, here is George. He has five. Screened by Young. Inside, Turner. A good finish at the rack off the slick feed. Turner's got 4 points this quarter.
Yeah, not a perfectly set screen there, but got him just enough room to get that shot off.
There's a screen by Gorton. Outside, Wall. Shot from 12. And there's Morris. That's good on the assist by Wall. And that's now 11 points for Markieff Morris. And the Washington Wizards last season, Doris, 41 up and 41 down, and ended up missing the playoffs for the first time in 3 seasons.
And remember, Kevin, this was a team that had made it to the second round and looked like a factor. And injuries played a role, and the East got better. And a new coaching staff will see if they can get back on the winning track.
Now, here is Morris. Following the miss by Miles Turner.
What a story from Markieff Morris, taking exactly one pick before his twin brother Marcus back in 2011.
He's had 6 attempts at the line, made 5 of them.
And from the line a season ago, 73%.
Now, gentlemen, 2 shots. Move shots.
And he can't get the first one. The Pacers making a change here. Brooks checked in. And that trip coming up empty, missing both.
And really, even the great ones have off nights, and this definitely qualifies as one of those for him. And the stroke definitely lacking confidence this quarter. Nothing on target.
Now here's Wall. Paul George unable to get his shot to go. For the lead, Wall's shot is off. Last outing for Indiana. They won that game against the Pistons at the Palace of Auburn Hills. Robinson kicks to Turner. Dish now to Brooks. Young, a screen on Wall. Brooks, the pass to Young. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Brooks. 14 points for Thaddeus Young.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Now here's Wall. He's got 5. There's Beal with the 3. It's rebounded by Indiana. Turner's got 6 rebounds in the game. Side George, and George with the stuff.
Oh, and he went for the two-hander on the slam using some muscle.
Some urgency from him there, sure. There's a screen by Gorton, and Beal kicks to Wall from the baseline. Good on the jump shot. Wall's got 7.
Called the spot-up opportunity, right? A nice confidence booster for John Wall.
Some nice passing here by Indiana. There's a screen by Robinson. Brooks with no one around. Rebound, Washington. And Wall kicks to Gortat. Back to Wall. Porter dishes to Wall. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot 2. That's on Aaron Brooks.
Yeah, John Wall has specialized in getting to the free throw line. He plays the game with breakneck pace.
And for a long time, the knock on Wall was that his outside shot, or lack of one, prevented him from being truly unguardable by defenses. But Dorsey went out and has put in a lot of work to improve his shot from distance.
Well, think about this, Kevin. Wall took more threes and shot a higher percentage than in any other year of his career last year. And he knows that the league is turning to be a three-point shot-focused league, and the value of a point guard that can make those kinds of shots with regularity. And if he ever gets that three-point percentage close to 40% or higher, he will be a terrifying matchup at the guard spot. We all know John Wall has been the subject of media scrutiny during his tenure in D.C., and so much expected out of him that when the team comes up short, obviously the blame falls on him. He is the leader, but sometimes it feels as if he's the only player to get blamed.
Well, with Wall in the media, Wall himself said that he'll make sure to read every critical piece about him. The thinking is that Dorsey can't just read articles when you're playing well. They'll use any criticism as motivation.
And isn't that, Kevin, exactly what the great players do? They find motivation wherever they can. And I think you have to give credit to John Wall for not shying away from criticism, right? What makes you get better other than when people are challenging you?
Here's what Washington's going with right now. Thornton comes in for Bradley Beal, and it's Burke in for John Wall. Satoransky, the pass to Thornton. Here's Satoransky. He dishes it to Oubre, pass to Thornton. Here's Satoransky, defended by George. And again, Washington, no good.
Sometimes you've got to get right in the shooter's grill to bother him, and that's what they did to him.
Jefferson kicks to Robinson, and finished off by Robinson.
Boy, spotted his teammate on the move, put the assist perfectly placed out in front of him, leading him right to the rack.
Thornton for three. It's good, the assist that time from Burke. Burke's got six assists in the game. For Indiana, they've gone 7 for 16 the second half from the field, shooting a bit under 50%. It's stolen. And here we go. Washington fast break. Here's Satoransky. And that misses. That would have put him up.
Ill-advised shot there.
You know, I really expected him to swing that one back around.
Took him no time at all on that one. 8 points for Robinson. Now here's Burke. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. He kicks it to Thornton. Now, here's Oubre. D right on him. Just five to shoot. Here's Burke. That doesn't go on the chance to tie. Pacers leading by three. Kicks it to Miles. To the left side wing. Robinson dishes to Jefferson. Again, Indiana. Here's Satoransky. He feeds it to Burke. Pass to Satoransky. Dishes it to Gortat. Swing gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
Fellas, we know this guy plays a physical brand of basketball. Gortat is going to make the officials make a call.
This will make five trips now to the free throw line for him tonight.
And just a shade over 70% from the line a season ago, that's an area I'm sure he wants to improve. They're not doing themselves any favors with their free throw shooting this half.
Otto Porter Jr., he's checked in for Satoransky. Sinks the second. Indiana leading by four. Brooks outside. Robinson sets a screen for Brooks. And here's George for three. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Brooks. George has got eight here in the quarter.
You can't afford to get him that kind of a look.
Come on, as a defender, you have got to fight harder to get through that screen and stay with your man.
Now, here's Burke. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one.
Well, make no mistake, this guy, a high percentage finisher inside. Gortat can finish with either power or finesse.
Knocked loose. Brooks, the pass to Jefferson. And again, it's Indiana converting.
And not quite as aggressive from outside as they were in the first half. Sticking to the high percentage shots, playing smart with the lead.
Now, here's Porter. 12 points for him. And that one's good. Burke.
Well, the basketball IQ on display for Otto Porter makes the right read there.
Brooks outside. And it's going to be a three-second call. And a chance now to review the shot chart.
Well, you have to think that he is going to look to go to the rim a little more often going forward because the three ball just hasn't been there. Sometimes it seems he's not getting his feet set or rushing his shooting motion, but either way, it just ain't falling.
Wizards trail by five. Burke kicks to Porter. And one reason why Otto Porter saw a huge increase in his role is that, Doris, he was able to develop a three-point shot that had teams, giving him a lot of respect, and then they had to adjust to. He was always strong going to the rim, but now defenses had to follow him out to that three-point line.
Well, as you know, Kevin, having a consistent three is such a big deal now for perimeter players. Porter at 6'8 has a smooth release and no problem shooting over the arms of smaller defenders who might rotate to him. And he's developed a nice little pull-up shot. If teams ever overextend, he can just step back and knock down a two.
And Porter drops them both.
I think the thing I like best about Otto Porter, his versatility and long arms, because it allows him to impact the game in so many ways.
Now here's Jefferson, 13 points in the game. Brooks kicks to George. To the middle, down to five on the shot clock, and Jefferson gets it to go.
I'm sorry, that's poor defense down low again. It's been a mismatch thus far in the paint.
Inside, here's Oubre. It's good, the assist that time from Burke. Oubre's got 6 points.
And guys, the D has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that trip.
Jefferson setting the pick for George. Pass to Miles. And there are the Pacers with another bucket.
You know, that's strong teamwork leading right to the basket. He put it in the shooting pocket at just the right time.
Burke kicks to Gortat. Robinson against Thornton. Back to Gortat. Nice ball movement by Washington. It's Porter outside. Pacers with the rebound. Jefferson's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Miles dishes to Brooks. Outside, George. No good. The third quarter comes to a close. Indiana out in front. They're up by five. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from Indianapolis. Got a great game on our hands as we welcome you back. The fourth quarter of action getting started. Wizards trail by five. A moment now to reset the lineups, brought to us by Gatorade, all fueled up here for the fourth quarter. So on the floor for Washington, the always dangerous Wall and Beal of the backcourt. Morris pairs with Gortat down low, and it's Oubre in at the three. Good on the free throw. And the second free throw, good. Wizards trail by six. And Wall kicks to Gortat.
Oh, very confident inside. I'll tell you, Gortat's mentality, if you don't foul me, I'm scoring it every single time.
Gortat. free throw good from Gortat. Free throws good from Arjen Gortat. And so it's Indiana with it. They lead by four. To the inside. Here's
And this sort of awesome dunk is one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game.
Well, there's a swagger out there. You can see it on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either. Here's Beal following the score by Indiana. Shot on the wing, and he nails the jumper.
He's gotten a little bit more selective with his two-point jumpers, but that's a shot Beal hits with regularity.
The feed to Young. A little over a minute of the fourth quarter gone right now. Here's Turner, and he gets the friendly spin, and that one drops. And the Pacers lead by six.
I love how he used his height advantage on that shot.
The big guy showing off his range on that jumper.
Al Jefferson is checked in for Miles Turner. That free throw good from Gortat. Both free throws good from Gortat. Pacers leading by four. Fourth quarter now. We're about a minute and a half in. And he gets the bucket. And that's now 10 points for Teague.
Teague knows exactly when to release that floater where nobody on the floor can get to it.
Wizards trail by six. Outside Beal. Morris kicks to Oubre. Nice ball movement by Washington. There's a screen by Gortat. Wall's shot is good.
He's been heating it up since the break, getting some excellent looks right now.
For Indiana, they've gotten all three of their shots to drop here in the fourth quarter. They came out of the break on a roll. Here's Robinson. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
And with the offense getting right to the rim, at least they saved the layup.
He misses the free throw. Good on the second free throw.
Well, the critical free throw was the one to make it a two-possession game, and he got it.
Outside, Beal. Feeds it to Oubre. There's the pass to Morris. No good on the shot. A bit long that time.
Defensive positioning so important, and he could not have played him better there.
Miles, the pass to Robinson. Jefferson setting the pick for Robinson. Here's Young. The shot missing. Now Washington takes it the other way. The dish to Beal. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
Oh, this guy's so explosive. And John Wall knows how to draw contact when he gets to the rack.
And the first one at the line is good. And so John Wall nails both of them.
He's forcing the action now, finally getting to the charity stripe after no freebies in the first half.
Miles, that's for two, and it doesn't even draw iron.
Not really sure what he was thinking about on that shot. That is not high IQ basketball.
No, and it looked like he got a bit ahead of himself and just couldn't pull back.
Now, here is Morris. Here's Gortat. No good there. Jefferson with some nice deep. Fast break. Here comes Indiana from deep. Miles. And that comes off the assist by Jeff Teague. Teague's got his ninth assist in the game now. Wall dishes to Beal. Up top, Morris. Now, here's Oubre. Defended by Miles. From deep, Wall. The Wizards with another miss.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside.
Teague kicks to Young. Miles the pass to Jefferson. Gortat with the rebound. Gortat's got 8 rebounds in this game. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
And they need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Down low. Pacers with the rebound. Robinson's got 4 rebounds in this game. Passes it to Jefferson. Now here's Teague. He dishes it to Miles. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him. And he knocks down the first one. And both free throws good for Jefferson. Wizards trail by 8. Outside, Wall. He kicks it to Morris. Morris with the screen for Wall. He feeds it to Gortat. Hits some rim on the way in, and the bucket's good. Gortat's got 23.
Listen, he can hit the mid-range, and the baseline is his sweet spot. Gortat loves it there.
Outside, T. Kicks it to Miles. Shot clock at 6. Robinson dishes to Jefferson. Gortat with the steal. Beal from long range. They grab their own miss. That's in, and the Pacer lead is cut down to 4 on the bucket from Morris.
You know, defense forgets about Morris and pays the price. He loves to score and can do it a number of ways.
Young outside. Dishes it to T. And there's the call on Marcin Gortat. That's his 5th foul.
And you've got to be more careful in that situation. That's his 5th foul, and now he's walking a fine line.
The Pacers making a change here. Servin's checked in. Teague against Wall. It's Miles atop the key. And an air ball on that one. Way off. Wizards trail by 4. Outside, Wall. To the paint. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
And he's been to the line much more here than he was in that first half. He's not playing nearly as tentatively as he was earlier.
And that one misses. Paul George, he's checked in for Indiana.
Yeah.
That one misses. Pacers leading by four. Outside Teague. Pass to Young. The feed to George. And the Pacers can't get it to go. Washington's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Here's Gortat. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two.
All the officials are all over that one.
First free throw is good. He hits one and misses one, each at the line.
And last season, Paul George, getting back to the All-Star game, I mean, well documented, going through that awful compound fracture in his leg, and said that that All-Star appearance was the most meaningful one of his career. And one of my favorite players and people in our game. It's just really great to see him back and playing at such a high level.
And the Pacers asking George to play more power forward last season. He was a little apprehensive, I think, Greg, initially, especially coming off that injury.
Yeah, and he ended up mostly guarding on the wing. They let C.J. Miles do the dirty work on the block.
The
extra space afforded by their spread-out attack allowed him to flourish at the offensive end.
And the first one drops. And Washington making a change here. Porter's checked in. He doesn't get the second one.
Listen, they're still right in this thing. Missing that free throw, though, keeps this a two-possession deficit.
The shot by George, no good. Wizards trail by four. Morris passes to Wall. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
A veteran move right there. John Wall gets him off his feet with the up fake. Pretty.
First one falls for. And so John Wall nails both of them. And it's the Pacers with the ball. A two-point game. Teague kicks to Young. George against Porter. Inside, Miles. Gortat with the defensive effort. Washington's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Teague against Wall. Morris with a screen on Teague. And here's Wall outside. Again, the miss by Wall. Pacers have gone 5 of 12 from the field entering the fourth quarter. Miles dishes to Robinson. Pass to George. To the middle. The kick out to Young. From deep. George missing again.
Wow, what a rough second half for him shooting the basketball. Maybe you adopt a pass-first mentality at this point.
There's Beal with the three. And the rebound goes to the Pacers. Teague's got his third rebound tonight. Now the pass to Young. Indiana moving the ball around. Outside Teague, just five on the clock. Screen by Young. George, that's a two-pointer. George missing again.
And guys, this has got to be more of a team effort. Right now, he's playing all for himself.
Wall passes to Beal. To tie it up. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
Few shots, gentlemen.
Hey, guys, you have to like the way Beal is working himself to the free throw line. Great scorers make a living there. You know, I think with the injuries that Bradley Beal has had to deal with in his career, it has taken a toll on his development. He's never played a full season in the NBA, and it's pretty hard to maximize your game when you're always fighting back from injury.
With Beal, he said himself that he might need to be on a minute restriction for the rest of his career. Doris, that's not a good sign.
No, it's not, Kevin. In the past, Beal has played quite a bit every time he's been available, so this would be a tough adjustment if that happens. For Beal, you need to do whatever it takes to stay healthy on the floor. He's a big-time talent, but he can't help his team if he's injured more often than not.
And it's George again missing.
And you know what? If you're the defense, you got him right where you want him. Let him keep shooting those threes because he's been brutal in this half.
Now, here is George. Here's Young to stop the drought. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. And that one misses. Good on the second free throw.
Well, I mean, a semi-productive trip to the free throw line, but we'll see whether or not it costs him.
And Wall kicks to Morris. Feeds to Gortat. And here's Wall outside. And the rebound goes to the Pacers.
Listen, that's a look he can hit, but right now he can't throw it in the ocean.
Robinson kicks to T. Knocks down the three ball. And the Pacers lead by five.
Number 32.
So it's Washington now. Right side Wall to the paint, and the call will be against Jeff Teague. So that will be his second foul of the game. We're in the bonus. We'll go to the line to shoot two.
Shooting two.
No good on that one.
And the number of fouls he's drawn has resulted in a bunch of trips to the line. So even if he doesn't make them all, it still had a positive effect.
Al Jefferson, he's checked in for Indiana. No good at the stripe this time. And second misses also. Pacers leading by five. George with the ball. Now guarded by Porter. Finished off by Jefferson.
Now flying high and throwing it down with the one hand.
Woo, one of his favorite moves right there, guys. Now here's Wall. There's a screen by Gortat. And an air ball on that one. Way off. T kicks to Jefferson. And Jefferson throws it down.
Really, really good possession there. They've never lost their focus, even as the game's gotten tight.
You know, a few more possessions like that one, and they can put the finishing touches on this game. They just have to have effective trips like that one.
Two open that time. Made it look too easy. And that's now 17 points for John Wall. .124 left here in the fourth quarter. 13 feet away. Porter pulls it in. Porter's got four rebounds now tonight. The dish now to Wall. Morris with a screen on Teague. And Wall kicks to Gortat. It's stolen by Jefferson. George dishes to Young. In the corner, it's Robinson. Screen by Jefferson. Here's George. Good, and the assist goes to Robinson. And the Pacers lead by 8.
And with that basket, you'd have to think this lead is secure.
Yeah, I wouldn't take my foot off the gas just yet, but it's never safe to assume any lead is safe in this league.
There's a screen by Gortat. And Wall kicks to Gortat. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot 2.
Now, gentlemen, 2 shots. 2 shots.
And the first of 2, no good, heartbreaker. And the second of 2 is good. That narrows the gap to 7.
You know, he doesn't shrink the lead as much as he should have. That hurts a bit.
Guys, you've got to think a basket here would seal.
No question. That would be all she wrote.
A 3 from George. That one's not going to go. And it's Washington the other way. Morris kicks the Wall. Sinks it. And now they trail by just 4.
Oh, you love to see guys come through in the clutch. A nice play by John Wall.
Honestly, just doing what they have to in order to get the basketball back.
At the line for your Pacers, Glenn Robinson III, taking 2 shots.
He hits the first one, and that puts them up by 5. And so he drops them both. It's a 6-point ball game.
Yeah, they have to be feeling a little bit more comfortable after the free throws add to their lead.
Washington calls timeout. They trail by 6. 20 seconds left to play here in the 4th. Guys, your thoughts?
And I'm not sure the 2-point bucket does much here. I think they got to go for 3.
Unless it's an end one, a 2-pointer makes no sense. Unfortunately for them, the defense knows this too.
The tray. That shot is off. Great D that time from T. And an intentional foul right there.
You have to foul, but I'm sure they would have liked to foul someone different.
Shooting for Indiana, Paul George. Taking 2 shots.
Good on the first, and that makes it a 7-point lead. So he gets them both, and it's an 8-point game. Washington calls timeout. They trail by 8. 9 seconds left in the fourth quarter. What's your take, guys?
You know, you like the fight all the way to the end, but let's face it, guys, this one's over.
Well, no question. This is a teaching moment. They're just trying to come out of this with something positive.
Aransky, the pass to Burke. The Wizards with another miss. So it's Indiana picking up the win. Some good competition, but the hometown advantage and their ability to stay focused, I think, made the difference.
Yeah, and the first step in becoming a good team is your ability to win at home. And they really seem to revel in that opportunity. And this is what they came out to do.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much, Paul. Congrats on the win. Where is your team's attitude right now?
Continue to, you know, play together. And we can just stick to that, keep working, staying confident, keep defending, and knocking shots down. We'll be all right.
Looked like it all came together tonight, Paul. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for tuning in. Now we'll head over to the award-winning Ernie Johnson, who's not too far away. EJ?
The 2K Sports post-game show.
And Ernie Johnson here again with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. Without further ado, let's present our Jordan player of the game, Thaddeus Young.
Love watching the skill down low. He didn't even just beat them with the size tonight. He displayed great hands and great footwork. Great big man moves.
Well, his rebounding was a story for me tonight, guys. He couldn't have been any more ferocious on the boards. This game would have had a much different feel if he wasn't controlling the glass like that.
And that's it for tonight. But we've got a whole new NBA season ahead of us. For Shaquille O'Neal, for Kenny the Jet Smith, for Kevin Harlan, wherever he might be, and the entire 2K Sports crew, I'm Ernie Johnson. We'll see you again very soon.